EMS workers of Reddit, what's the most avoidable death you've ever seen? When patients don't take their medicine. Lots of type 2 diabetics don't take their metformin, or change their diet exercise simply out of denial, or they are too set in their ways, end up with bad kidney failure or heart problems. Additionally, had a patient who refused to take their medicine for their high blood pressure. No reason, just refused. Had a brain bleed on his brainstem, was a quadriplegic, on a ventilator, could not speak, move, or breathe on his own. He was in his 30s. Take your medicine, people. My fave is diabetics that walk barefoot, refuse to see a podiatrist check their feet. It is all fun and games until your toe falls off. I had a 32 meters admitted for multiple pulmonary embolisms. Turns out this was his second admission within 2 months, because he stopped taking his anticoagulant that was prescribed during his previous admission. His reasoning? They didn't feel like they were doing anything, so he stopped taking them. Due to this, he was then started on a different anticoagulant that requires weekly blood tests. So instead of just taking a pill with little follow-up, he had to live with weekly blood tests and a high-risk medication. I was an Army Combat Medic EMTB. The worst completely avoidable death was when we got a call that an Afghan soldier nearby was having chest pains, and their own medic was really concerned about it, so they sent him to our base. On the drive over, their convoy had to stop suddenly. One of the guys riding in the back of a pickup truck fell off the back because he wasn't wearing any kind of seat belt or harness. He probably would have been okay, but the truck behind them wasn't able to stop as quickly, so he got caught between the two. He probably would have survived, but he wasn't wearing his helmet either. His skull popped like a grape. Of course, in my opinion, 100% of the deaths I saw were completely avoidable. Especially because after nearly 2 decades of war, the US military pulled out, and the Taliban immediately retook the area. Men, women, children, and my brothers died for nothing. Oh, by the way, the chest pain guy was completely fine. There was absolutely nothing wrong with him. I used to be an ambulance officer, and on the job it was suicides. I had a guy slash his forearms with a knife, then realize he didn't want to go through with it. We got halfway to the hospital roughly before he checked out. The most avoidable death I've seen was my grandmother, though she went to hospital with a broken wrist. She then developed a staph infection, which meant a couple of days stay supposedly. The orderlies then dropped her while moving beds and broke her hip, which then led to her getting pneumonia and her subsequent death. From a healthy 69-year-old woman with a broken wrist to dead in a bit over a week. That's sadly a common problem. I'm not a physician, but I read about that in a law book about medical law. It's just frustrating to see that this apparently must be basic knowledge for doctors and nurses, and those medically trained people should be extra careful in these situations. It's hard to narrow it down to a specific one, but I assure you it involves family. That said, we just wanted to wait and see what happened. HMM, we can either play it safe and bankrupt our family, or we can wait till morning. Welcome to America. Play that game of roulette before. Am I having a heart attack or a panic attack? Welp, guess I'll find out soon either way. It was a really bad panic attack, thankfully. If this is a thing that you're regularly worried about, it might be worth the cost of buying a cheap ECG machine from eBay for a couple $100. Actually, I think Americans call them EKG because they made their acronym from the German spelling of electrocardiogram. American here. It is called EKG here. Didn't know there was another spelling for it. I've posted this before, but I once had a patient who had the look of someone with one foot in the grave, who had near complete blockages in all three of the main blood vessels that supply the heart. That's not super unusual, and with open heart surgery she probably had an excellent chance of a good outcome. What was different about this case was she had apparently had the same thing happen to slightly less degrees, not once, not twice, but 3 times over the previous 6 months, and had refused surgery each time in favor of a Mediterranean diet. She decompensated very quickly, was emergently sedated and intubated, and flown out to the big city hospital for the surgery she should have received 6 months ago. I'm pretty sure she did survive, but did not have a great quality of life. Due to cause massive internal bleeding from using a jackhammer incorrectly. By the time his wife called 911, he was all but dead, and had filled several small trash cans with blood he had vomited. Big guy too. Had to use fireman and the sling to get him down the stairs. The whole time we were working on him and getting him down the stairs, his wife was nagging him about not hiring someone to break up the pavement, that he was such an idiot for trying to do it himself. She didn't know these were the last words he'd hear from her. How did he use it incorrectly, if I may ask? Was he hit by a concrete shrapnel? Wait, how did he cause internal bleeding? Most of the traumatic deaths I've seen could have been prevented in one way or another by wearing a seatbelt, driving sober, or just obeying simple traffic laws, for instance not running from the police on your sport bike. But I think the most easily avoidable deaths I've seen can be contributed to a lack of basic self-care, years of a sedentary lifestyle, inappropriate diet, and medical non-compliance or lack of preventive care lead to the large majority of deaths that I've seen. It's easy to ignore how our current choices may affect us later in life, but by making simple, healthy changes in our lives now, we can have a more graceful ascent into our later life. Was an EMT, but this was prior to that, when I was just a volunteer firefighter, got called to a house fire, when a grandmother had woken up her granddaughter, and got safely out of the house. Unfortunately, she decided to go back into the house, and died of smoke inhalation mere feet from the door. Since it was a ways out in the county by the time we got there, the house was fully involved, meaning we couldn't go in, had to fight the fire back to get through the door. Moral of the story, don't go back into a building in fire where everyone is out safe. Things can be replaced but you can't. People doing dumb things on the job. Moving an industrial generator? Sure, stand directly under it while the loft is lowering it down. Have a truckload of 7,500-pound I-beams that need to be offloaded off a flatbed? Sure thing, do it by yourself with a forklift. Have a wood planer at a furniture factory that gets jammed? Go ahead, stick your arm in there to unjam it. But did they look cool while doing it? That's the important part for these macho man. Husband is a paramedic, so I asked him. Background info, we live in a regional area of Australia with a lot of farmer super blokey she'll be right type of guys. His response was DIY surgery. We may be regional, but we have a hospital, we have numerous medical clinics, and ambulances will always be able to get to you. If you shoot a nail into your neck with a nail gun, and you're still conscious, there is absolutely no reason at all to attempt to remove it yourself with a kitchen knife. Had a non-compliant diabetic repeat customer have the sixth heart attack in 1 year. Double amputee, 230 pounds, refuses to use his monitor, just shoots himself with insulin whenever he thinks he needs it. He was eating his third Big Mac when he got his heart attack. Flatlined during his ride to the ER. Took 6 hours to stabilize the idiot, and the first thing he does when he wakes up, calls his buddies to bring him McDonald's. Obvious answer would be all of the overdoses, but also many incidents in nursing homes, where a patient will be found dead in the staff state they just saw them 30 minutes ago, when that is definitely not the case. The worst is a parent rolling onto their baby while asleep. I haven't had that call yet, but other crews did recently, and it is just devastating to all involved. Family, medics, police, fire, everyone. Probably any time someone could have worn a seatbelt but didn't. Or safety glasses, or Salisbury gloves. Till insulating gloves are called Salisbury gloves. I want some Salisbury steak now. When I first saw the post I was like, gloves made for handling steak? They keep your hands from being grilled. I literally always want Salisbury steak. I'll bet a lot in the US could say unfunded medication, lack of a life-saving procedure, or avoiding going to the doctor until it's too late. Also, guns plus alcohol, drugs, idiocy, anger issues, general life. Idiots in cars honestly scare me more than idiots with guns. A young child half-beated to death. We got there just in time. The poor kid was only 3 and was in cardiac arrest as we walked in. We saved the young one, rushed them to hospital, only to find out 3 days later they died of massive internal injuries and really bad head injuries. Still not completely over it. Guy stationed on a Coast Guard ship got hit in the head by a crane when it fell over. The crane operator didn't put down the outriggers, the big metal feet that stick out to stabilize the crane, and it fell over. Victim was in the wrong place at the wrong time, left behind 4 daughters and a wife. Probably just care staff inexplicably not doing CPR, even though they know how. Seems like they never do. I do, unless they have a DNAR in place. Not all us care staff are bad. Fatal, accidental gunshot wound caused by someone leaving a loaded assault rifle safety off lying on the kitchen counter in the presence of small children. I've heard plenty of patients just absolutely refuse care when, have a heart attack, and then got called back a few hours later for the cardiac arrest. Got stuck in Key Lanyard, while opening the front door, belly full of Arbys. Arbys came up, part died. Suicide, I'd guess. Almost every car accident is the result of someone texting or driving like an idiot. Motorcycles, repeatedly, every time.